YouTube. So a couple of years ago, me and my Hyperlite homies, Cody Hunnicutt and Parker Swope, went down to Orlando and did some off-season wakeboarding. While we were there, we met up with some legends of the sport, and we also got a tour of the Nautique factory. Are you ready?
I know I'm ready.
Most kids spend their school days playing mainstream sports, dreaming one day to make it to the big leagues. Yet others spend their days wanting more. Not satisfied with a team sport mentality, they seek out ways to show their individuality and personal style, seeking out a sport that lets them excel as an individual and make their own mark from an early age. Follow us as we watch three young wakeboarders show us what it truly means to be growing up Hyperlite.
Hey, what's up? I'm Kane Ward, 7 years old, from Coleman, Alabama.
Yo, it's cold and dreary down here in the southeast. I think I'm going to go hook up with my buddies, Cody and Parker, and we're going to go get some riding in Orlando. Let's meet my boys.
I'm Cody Hunnicutt, I'm 14 years old, and this is my hometown, the Music City, Nashville, Tennessee.
Hi, I'm Parker Swope, and I'm a 15-year-old from Santa Fe, Texas, and I've been wakeboarding for about 6 years now.
It's time to hit the road. We'll see you in Orlando.
Finally made it to Orlando, Florida, heading over to J.D. Webb's house. I was trying to escape the cold in Tennessee, but unfortunately, it was just as cold.
J.D. Webb heard about us coming to Orlando, so he invited us to stay at his house. I can tell he was very excited about it.
I was not excited for those little punks to come to my house. Yeah, you know, I was super pumped to have the kids coming out to the house. When I was young, at their age, I looked up to Shaun Murray, and he was like one of my idols. And to be able to kind of mentor these kids, see the next generation of wakeboarders and how they're really pushing it, like it was super special for me to like get to take them around Orlando and just have a good time on the boat.
Hey, what's going on, J.D. Webb? We got all the little Groms here today. We're heading up to Nautique to check out how all the boats are built. Really excited to have these guys in town. We're gonna get some riding in, have some fun, and let these boys show me up on a wakeboard.
You
kind of wait for them to at least start the video.
We're about to take a tour of the Nautique factory, and we're gonna slap Hyperlite stickers everywhere.
Everything Hyperlite.
Let's go.
All right, we're about to get our first victory.
Just got here to Nautique. This is Anthony Monaco, my team manager, and we're gonna take all the little Groms to the factory and kind of show them how these beautiful boats are made.
Cool.
So are you ready?
Thank you.
Yeah, awesome. Yeah.
No worries.
Touring the Nautique factory, we walked outside and noticed that Sammy Roberts' personal G23 was sitting outside, so we decided to go pay it a visit. This is Sammy's G, custom G, and we're about to go take it out wakeboard on it. We didn't take it out on a wakeboard set, but we may have left a reminder that we were there.
Finally, after the Nautique tour, we got to head up to the legendary J.D. Webb's house.
couple sets that afternoon.
The water was freezing, but we wanted to ride so bad.
For JD to let us crash at his house, and just wakeboarding with him was pretty insane.
So when we got back to JD's house, Parker wasn't hungry, but me and Cody were starving. So we decided to go get something to eat, and we ran into some shady locals.
Hey man, nice hat. You guys wakeboard?
Yes, sir.
Who was that guy?
I don't know, but remember, Kane, don't talk to strangers.
Cody's right. We should be careful who we talk to.
Join us for the next episode of Growing Up Hyperlite. Boys set out to spin some laps at O-Dub. As if the trip couldn't get any better, they get a surprise message from a true icon of the sport and get where every wakeboarder dreams of going.
Shaun Murray's house.